bonita.
Es impresionante, ¿eh? Esta es en cherry, ¿no? Qué bonito, es un color increíble. Las dos esencias juntas, cherry y tulip wood. Guapísimo. Bueno, listo.
Designing furniture with Eric was mainly designing our home. And what he loved more about it was the movement. So he was always talking about the fact that the legs were changing positions and they were maybe not classically four, they were special legs.
Tiene cinco, ¿no? De patas fijas. Son cinco, porque son cuatro por aquí y después hay la extensión.
And this idea of moving the house and having the possibility that the pieces of furniture could appear and disappear was really something that he loved. And now, 20 years after Eric's death, we have this possibility of reproducing the furniture of the home. At the time, we were designing our home with a really the desire to make something special. It was like an occasion to make experiments. And furniture and discovering how to use wood was really part of these discoveries that we were doing.
Es que roble rojo, porque no lo conocía. Ahora que lo conozco, solo quiero roble rojo.
Y luego lo mismo, el acabado le pega el aceite.
Le pega el aceite, sí. Porque esto es como muy, muy rústico.
Muy rústico y muy natural. Y
I think I had learned a lot from American hardwood about wood and about the fantastic way wood can contribute to preserve the environment and to have a kind of a cyclone, you know? We are using the wood, but in the same time we're using it, the trees are growing. So I think I learned a lot about that, and this made me very conscious about the fact that wood is a very ecological material, and not only to produce furniture, but also to produce fantastic building, big structures. So American hardwood actually taught me a lot about how wood really could be the material of the future. And it's surprising because it was a material of the past, and now we are discovering it again. And we are discovering that this can be a kind of a help for the situation of the world.
O sea, los que nos gusta siempre es el aceite. ¿Qué es este?
Este es el acrílico.
Sí, ese también está bien, ¿eh?
El acrílico también es bonito, sí. ¿Eh?
Creo que en este igual quedaba bonito este con el segundo, ¿eh?
Y a ver el cherry al agua. Es este, ¿no?
Es este.
¿Qué prefieres? ¿Qué preferís? Bueno, esto es muy bonito, ¿eh? Hacer este contraste, yo creo que es guapísimo.
A miracle happened a few days ago. I was looking into the notebooks of Eric, and I found some very fine sketches. I was in a hurry, and I took a photo of that, and I sent it in the office. And then Neil from the office commented me and said, oh, there is a new table, no? I said, no, it's the old one, it's just a detail of it. And he said, no, it doesn't look like the old one. So I looked at it and I discovered that Eric had designed, drawn very clearly with measurements, a table which was never built.
Es que no llega hasta aquí, ¿eh? En los dibujos de Eric llega hasta aquí. En este dibujo hay esta pieza. Después escribe, no. Y hemos estado porque no corresponde una pata con la otra. Y creo que la pata que él acepta es la que va alargada en este sentido.
I think Eric was considered to be very crazy, but in a way he was very rational and very practical. He was an artist, so I was so happy to let him draw and to express his incredible art, which sometimes was absolutely magic. So never mind what I could tell him,
The result was always superior to what I had to imagine. He was very precise. He had a very strange way of being precise and also very quick in the same time. He was always putting a kind of a hidden signature. So in these pieces of furniture, it's very easy to find some hidden symbols. One is the M, which is Miralles, but if you turn the M, it's an E, like Enrique.
Pues es bonito porque a veces cambia el color, ¿no?
Esto tiene este tono un poco verdoso. Aquí le sale este tono un poquito rojito. Además, aquí va en este sentido, aquí va en el otro.
Me gusta todo.
The pieces are so complex. The point is that when you go and speak with the people of La Navarra, they never have any problem, and it's fantastic. They solve everything, and everything looks so simple.
Has visto que no me quejo de vosotros, ¿eh? No hacemos nada normal.
Parece casi fácil hacerlo. Es que estoy alucinada. Es que nosotros solo hemos visto los dibujos y las fotos.
Esto luego, si tenemos suerte, coincide y todo.
Exacto, ¿no? Y si tenemos muchísima suerte, se mueve.
It's really exciting to reproduce these tables with different type of woods. And also American type of woods. No, I know in the United States the trees are so big, so I imagine the wood to be really strong. But we love to choose also species which are usually not so common.
Maderas is a Spanish company with more than 50 years of expertise, based in three strategic business areas. We are importers and wholesalers of hardwoods, softwoods, tropical woods, boards, panels, floorings, etc. We are focused on giving support and also develop wood knowledge between architects, product designers, and also interior designers. So for Maderas, it's a huge pleasure to participate as wood donors in Benedetta's Tagliabue project called Perpetuum Mobile, in memoriam of the great architect Enric Miralles.
¡Buenos días a todos! ¡Qué cosa! La nueva pieza de casa. Ven, Gus, mira qué cosa. Es que es maravilloso cómo funcionan los topes. Porque funcionan así como tope y en el mismo tiempo, cuando se baja, funcionan dando ritmo. Queda muy bonita esta cosa de las solo cinco patas para una mesa tan enorme. Para una mesa tan enorme. Y claro, esas son un poco más anchas, esta es un poquito más estrecha. Pero bueno, también cuando lo miras, no te das cuenta, ¿no? Se oye hasta ruido bonito, ¿no? Cuando pasas el cal... ¿Escucha? ¿Escucha? Es fantástico. ¿Sabes que a mí el tulip verde me cae simpático? Las vetas verdes quedan elegantísimas. Y a mí me encanta esto. Tenemos el corazón aquí, que va, que va a ser un corredor. ¡Wow! ¡Mira! Claro, los japoneses hacen así, ¿no? Se sientan en la ducha. Entonces aquí tienen como todas sus cosas, sobre todo una cosa de estas que se tira de encima. Y están como horas sacando... A ver la diferencia entre cerezo y roble rojo. Porque estos dos son roble rojo. Cerezo, tulipwood y arce, que es maravilloso. Entonces, esta es el roble. Se ve súper bonito el cambio de las diferentes maderas.
Son unos dibujos fantásticos. Es bellísima. Es bellísima.
Yo creo que es la más bonita.
Es a gusto tocarla, exacto. La madera es viva, ¿no? Dicen.
Me impacta. Me impacta el color. La textura.
My aim is to make everybody know this splendid invention by Rick and know his personality better and know many of his games, no? Because he was a person who loved to make games and considering life like a game.
He was believing that ideas are in the air and you need to be awakened enough to get the ideas which are flying in the air a little before the others.